Morning and welcome to our benefice service for this, the Feast of Pentecost. And a massive thank you to Owen, Derry and the Winslow Choir for the music and the prayers. We meet in the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. What God has prepared for those who love him, he has revealed to us through his Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything. Therefore, let us in penitence open our hearts to the Lord, who has prepared good things for those who love him. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed. Through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault, we are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we sing the glory. Through the merits grace of Christ Jesus, our Saviour, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. In a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared amongst them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages, as the Spirit gave them the ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one of them heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how it is that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's amazing deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall see dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." This is the word of the Lord. Our hymn to welcome the gospel is number 245, "Gracious Spirit, Holy Ghost."
Thank you.
Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful people and kindle in them the fire of your love. Alleluia. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John. It was evening on the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood amongst them and said, "Peace be with you." After this he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." This is the Gospel of the Lord. May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, that first Pentecost must have been a very strange experience for all who were there and experienced it. This Pentecost is also very strange for us as we experience it, me here and you there. But you see, experience is at the very heart of Pentecost. And the experience we are talking about is that of the very presence of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit that breathed life into his church and continues to breathe life into the church. Pentecost isn't the result of theological thinking, human reasoning, doctrine or dogma, but it is the action of the activist God who has charged his church to keep building the kingdom of God here on earth as in heaven. So the question for us simply becomes this: are we open to the living presence amongst us of the activist God? The God who wants to shape not only our language, but our behaviour. In fact, our entire orientation to the world. The health warning is this: if we want to keep our faith secure, quiet, passive, and domesticated, Pentecost is not for us. If we believe in preserving the status quo at all costs, then again, Pentecost is not for us. If we prefer to stay quiet and render our faith a purely private matter, then again, Pentecost is simply not for us. And whilst I am at it, if we believe that because we are not all gathered in one place at the same time as those first Christians were, and if we believe that the Holy Spirit is not alive and active and desirous of working among us and through us in these strange times, then Pentecost is not for us. Pentecost is the day in the liturgical calendar. It's a great feast of the church, but it is so much more than that. It is God's invitation to continually and literally be inspired by the ongoing work of the Holy Spirit, as we have already prayed in the prayer of preparation. The Spirit who is alive and active, and whose role is to make sure that we too, as the people of God, remain alive and active. An amusing anecdote. This week, as a response to Mark's Little Acorns, which will be live at 10:30, lest you didn't know, one of the children, Monty, was discovered by their mum drawing a collection of holy doves. He drew a dove in a tree with a koala bear, a dove with a fire engine, a dove with a policeman arresting a baddie. I wonder who that might have been. A dove with a car mechanic. Well, why did he do this? Well, the answer, according to Monty, was fairly obvious. The Holy Spirit is everywhere. That is, if we are open to God breathing his Spirit into us, both individually and collectively, as the body of Christ. But again, the health warning. To be open to the Holy Spirit means being open to the active and activist God, the God who wants his people to be ever more lavish and hospitable, the God who wants us to take us out of every comfort zone, the God who wants us to learn to communicate his love for all in new ways, in diverse tongues, the God who wants me and you to become theologically bilingual, the God who wants us to speak in the vernacular as people, all sorts of people will understand it. For you see, the Pentecost is the fulfillment of two very special prophecies. The one that Peter spoke about in relation to Joel, but for me also the Song of Simeon, where we start, in effect, the whole Christian journey from incarnation to Pentecost. Where, if you remember, that earliest sage of the church makes the most astonishing spirit-filled declaration. My eyes have seen the salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people, a light to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Well, our job as spirit-filled Christians is to offer that Christ light to all people in the vernacular they will understand. But two more health warnings. First, to be inspired by the Holy Spirit also means to be a person who is demonstrably, for a spirit-filled faith will always be demonstrable, committed to the ministry of forgiveness and reconciliation. This is the upfront and activist message of the short gospel reading set for today. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. What a sobering thought. We, through our willingness to forgive or otherwise, have the power to either liberate others or to keep them imprisoned within the walls of their own failings and sin. And my final health warning is this. If we are to be truly inspired by the Holy Spirit, the universal and activist spirit, then we, like Simon Peter on the day of that first Pentecost, might need to be prepared for some pretty difficult conversations, even to be sneered at. For part of the role of the Spirit is to equip us, you and me, to speak truth, Christian truth, to power and those that sneer. That's what it means to be prophetic. And as we know from Jesus' own experience, a prophet can often be without honour, even in his own country. Pentecost is one of the great festivals of the church. But it is so much more than this. It is the invitation to be inspired, literally inspired, by the indwelling of the activist God, the God who desires nothing more than to reach out and speak to all people in all places, in tongues they can understand, offering the hand of forgiveness, reconciliation, liberation, and friendship. Pentecost is God's invitation into a life of holy dishonour for the sake of the building of the kingdom here on earth as in heaven. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit in the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So let us pray. On this day of Pentecost, we pray for people whose lives are taking an unwanted and unexpected path, that they may feel God's Spirit and strength as they navigate new ways. We remember all people who are missing their friends and families and pray that they know how much they are loved. We think and pray for all those who are too young or too confused to understand what is happening, that God's Spirit will bring them peace and patience. Dear Lord, in this time of trouble, help us to focus on the wonderful things in this world and all that you have given us. Help us to remember how the natural world feeds us in many ways, and not to let the clouds hide the beauty of the earth, the beauty of the skies. For the love which from our birth over and around us lies, Lord of all, to thee we raise our thankful prayers, love and praise. So let us give thanks for these warm days, for everything in the natural world, and especially birdsong, which seems so beautiful during this strange time, remembering the presence of the Holy Spirit as the dove. Dear Lord, at this difficult time, please be with those who are isolated alone. We give thanks for all the kind people who are helping out doing shopping and making telephone contact with the lonely and anxious. We pray that there will not be a resurgence of the virus as lockdown is relaxed. We pray for wisdom in policy making. We ask this in the name of our Saviour, Jesus Christ our Lord. Dear Lord, we thank you for giving us your Holy Spirit. Let us be a fire for you and help our light to shine always. And we pray for those who have sought our intercession, for Mary Claire, Roy, Tim, Storm, Carolyn, Nigel and Lisa, Heather, Ethan, Tobias, Anne, Michael, Penny, Jenny and Peter, all at Swan House, Margaret, Johnny, Tom, Harry, Jenny, Isabel, Carol, Jenny, Joe W and Becky. And from the memorial book, we remember Jean Gaskell, Richard Stone, and Iris Barnes. And in a moment of quiet, we bring our own deepest intercessions, pleas, and petitions to the God who is always with us through his Holy Spirit, the God whose name is love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. God has made us one in Christ. He has set his seal upon us as a pledge of what is to come. He has given him the Spirit to dwell in our hearts. Alleluia. So the peace of the Lord be always with you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given in human hands of man. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. The Lord is here, and his Spirit is with us. So lift up your hearts and give thanks to the Lord our God, for it is right to give him thanks and praise. It is indeed right, it is our duty and our joy always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. This day we give you thanks because in the fulfilment of your promise, you pour out your Spirit upon us, filling us with your gifts, leading us into all truth, and uniting peoples of many tongues in the confession of one faith. Your Spirit gives us grace to call you Father, to proclaim your gospel to all nations, and to serve you as a royal priesthood. Therefore, we join our voices with angels and archangels, and with all those in whom the Spirit dwells, to proclaim your glory, the glory of your name, forever praising you and singing. Took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise.
Blessing the Lord.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. For though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, we are not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and we shall be healed. The body of Christ given for us. And the blood of Christ shed for us. Faithful God, who filled the promises of Easter by sending us your Holy Spirit and reopening to every race and nation the way to eternal life, open our lips by your Spirit, that every tongue may tell of your glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope that you have set before us, so that we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Spirit of truth leads you into all truth. Give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and strengthen you to proclaim the word and works of God, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and among all who you love, care for, and pray for this Pentecost and always. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.